If you think catching bugs is just running around with a net, you're sorely mistaken. Although, yes, that's a big part of it. In order to catch insects and spiders for DNA sequencing and biodiversity research, ecologists have developed a few tricks of their own. At Hakai Institute's recent terrestrial bioblitz on Calvert Island, we pulled out all the stops to capture as many tiny critters as possible. Entomologist Chris Ernst digs a small pit for a container to catch bugs moving along the ground. The container is filled with antifreeze to kill and preserve the critters that fall in. You've probably noticed that moths gather around porch lights and street lamps. To attract the nocturnal crowd, Miko Pentensari sets up a white sheet with a black light directed onto it. Throughout the night, he checks in every so often to see what sorts of moths have gathered. No, it's not a tent. Malaise traps are used to catch flying insects like flies, wasps, or bees. They work best when set up in a transition zone between two different environments, like the edge of a forest. While there are different types of malaise traps, the basics are the same. Insects fly into the trap wall and are funneled into a collecting vessel attached at the highest point. To catch ants crawling on a tree, a sampling container with a preservative is simply attached to a pop bottle that's been cut in half. In order to attract wood-boring beetles, a series of funnels are strung up together to mimic a tree, with a preservative mixture in the container at the bottom. Yet another passive bug collecting method is to spray paint bowls red, yellow, and blue and fill each with a little soap and water. The different colors attract different flying critters. Blue vane traps attract some pollinating insects like bees, wasps, and flies, again using color. The insects fly towards the blue and yellow coloring and into the trap, where they are captured in water. Bead sheets capture cryptic critters that hide in vegetation. Once again, Miko Pentensari demonstrates by holding the bottom sheet under branches while he whacks them with a stick. Critters that land on the sheet are then collected by hand. Berlese funnels work on the principle that insects and other arthropods that normally live in soil and litter will respond negatively to light. A light source is used to force the insects to move downward in the tube through a grate where they will be funneled into a container of ethanol for preservation. Don't worry, these ecologists aren't slurping insects. Aspirators, or pooters as we prefer to call them, are a favorite amongst our BioBlitz team. To catch spiders, Darren Copley puts one end of the tube, which contains a gauze filter, in his mouth, aims the other end at the bug, and inhales. That's our list. Happy collecting!